Hello friends, today in the second lecture of analysis of a simple truss, we will be starting with the types of trusses. So at first, let us check what are the types of truss. So here is the classification of the truss, where the first one is perfect truss and second one is imperfect truss. Now the truss which is perfect has this formula, M is equal to 2J minus R. And the truss which is imperfect has the formula M not equal to 2J minus R. Now what is J, what is M, what is R, we'll be discussing later. But before that, again, imperfect truss is classified in two types, deficient truss and redundant truss. So the formula for deficient truss is M less than 2J minus R, and formula for redundant truss is M greater than 2J minus R. So now we'll discuss about what do you mean by M, what do you mean by J, and what do you mean by R. Let us consider this example of a truss for our consideration. So here M is the number of members that are straight members. This green one resembles the number of members. 1, 2, 3, 4, let us write down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this one becomes 7. So number of members here are 7. J is number of joints. We can say for a truss they are pinned joints or hinge joints. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So J becomes 5. And about R, R is the number of reactions. So reactions will be for the supports. This is for hinge and this is for roller. For hinge there will be one vertical, one horizontal. For roller there will be one vertical. So total number of reactions will be 1, 2 and 3. So small r is 3. So now from this M, J and R we can calculate as per the formulas and declare the type of truss from the following. But this was just for the example. We will have individual types of example and there will solve numerous examples. So this was just the classification of truss, but now we'll get into the deeper, that is perfect, imperfect, deficient, redundant truss. Here we can say number of member is equal to 2 into J minus R. So same is the thing here. For perfect truss, let us check the formula. We can say definition. A truss which satisfies the necessary condition M is equal to 2J minus R is called a perfect truss. Here this formula has been satisfied, or we can say condition has been satisfied. We can consider this truss and we can calculate M, R and J. Here it is having hinge joint, it is roller, and here 20 kN load is acting on this truss. This type of structure is known as truss. So number of members are 5. Let us count 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So M is equal to 5. Number of reactions are 1 vertical for this hinge, horizontal for this hinge and vertical for this roller. So total 3 reactions. Number of joints are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there are 4 joints. Now according to the formula, M is equal to 2J minus R. 5 is equal to 2 into 4 minus 3, that will be 5 is equal to 5. So LHS is equal to RHS and the truss is perfect, or we can say stable. So if the truss is perfect, we can say it is stable. It is not collapsing on application of the load. And the word perfect indicates economical too. There are no extra members. There are no deficient members, that is there are no less members. There are perfect number of members and the truss is economically stable. And that is why it is known as perfect truss. Then the second one here was imperfect truss, where M not equal to 2J minus R. So let us understand these both, where M is less than 2J minus R and M is greater than 2J minus R. So we can say members less than 2J minus R and greater than 2J minus R. The first one we'll understand, deficient truss. You can just take a screenshot wherever required. So what the definition of the deficient truss tell us is a truss which satisfies M less than 2J minus R is called deficient truss. So number of members are less, there is some deficiency, so it is known as deficient truss. So when the load is applied on the truss, it will collapse and deform to the new shape. So this type of truss will fail on the application of the load because the number of members are less than required. So here let us count M. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. J's joints are 1, 2, 3 and 4. Again, joints are also 4. And regarding reactions, 1 vertical, 2 horizontal, 3 again vertical. So 3 reactions. So here 4 less than 2 into 4 minus 3. So 4 is less than 5. Yes, the truss is imperfect, or we can say it is unstable, or it is deficient. Deficient. There is some deficiency because the number of members are less. So here the deficiency is of number of members. Here if we provide one more member, the truss will be perfect. But right now it is not perfect, and what thing will happen is this will change its shape. So it will take a shape like, we can say like this. This might be the new shape. So changing of the shape, we can say eligible of the strain is not applicable in the truss. This type of truss cannot be applied in the structure. It is deficient, imperfect or unstable. Now let us continue. The third one was redundant truss. Okay, where members are greater than 2J minus R. Let us check what thing happens then. According to the definition, a truss which satisfies M greater than 2J minus R. Members are more than required. It is called redundant truss. The axial forces of such truss members cannot be found out by simple equations. See, as we cannot calculate the reactions for a determinate beam very easily, we have to use different methods. Similarly, for this type of truss, it becomes indeterminate truss, or we can say indeterminate structure, where we need to apply different kinds of formulas, and analysis of such trusses were not very easy, where there are some extra members. Calculations of stresses in each member will be very difficult. But right now, let us just check the redundancy. So number of members are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Number of joints are as circled with this brown colored sketch pen, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here joints are 4. Regarding reactions, this one is vertical, this one is horizontal, again vertical, total are 3. Reactions are 3. So 6 is greater than 2 into 4 minus 3. So 6 is greater than 5, yes. So truss is redundant and imperfect. We are telling it imperfect because it is not economical. There are few more members than required. But it is redundant, it is stable. It will not collapse on applicable of the load. That is, if we are applying a 20 kN load here, this truss will not change its shape, but it will resist the force. So this is all about second lecture. In third lecture, we'll talk about internal resistance in the members, assumptions made in the analysis of the plane truss, and we'll go with the flow. But before that, we'll understand components of a roof truss. So let us terminate this session and we'll continue in our next session.